Hey guys, welcome to Laratips. In one of my earlier videos, I showed you how to format multi-level categories using has-many relationship. And in that case, whenever we formatted the category, let's say there were three levels of categories, then it would take four queries to perform that operation. But in this video, we'll just do query one time, which means there will be only one query and we'll use Laravel collection to format the category. And guys, here Julian, sorry if I mispronounce your name, he also asked for that, so I'm going to make that video. And if you haven't watched this video, then I would suggest you to watch this video first and then continue with this one. And now if I show you here in the database, I have many categories, and this I have shown in my previous video as well. There are four levels of categories in this table, and the one with no parent ID is the root categories. So now let us see how to do it using only one query. So here in the category model, let us create a static method and we'll call it tree, and we'll get all the categories here like this. In the first level, we only want the parent categories or the root categories. So we'll also now get the root categories. So here we'll say all categories where null parent ID. Now it will only give us the root categories from this all categories. So here we are not doing an extra database query, but we are doing this in a collection. Now let us loop through the root categories. For each root categories as category, and now here we will find the children of the root categories. So we'll say here root category children equals to dollar all categories where parent ID is equals to dollar root category ID. So here we'll look into all the categories, and any category that has the parent ID as this category, the root category, then that will be the children of the root category. So we'll do this. So if I show you here in the database, so I have here one as a parent ID, which means that this is the children of this category. And now here I'll just return dollar root categories. And here I don't have to assign it to any temporary variable or anything, because we are doing this in an object, and whenever we add any new property like this, then it will automatically get attached to that object. The original object will get mutated, so we don't have to assign it to any temporary variables. And now let us go here in the Tinkerbell and let us test it out. So here I'll say app models category, and I'll say tree like this, and you can see here I am getting this root category, so this ID with the one. If you see here, this is the root category, and if I just collapse it, then you can see here this is also the category or the root category. Now here it also has the children here like this, and this second category, the root category, also has the children. So we successfully added the children to the root categories, but this category with the ID of 6 also has its children. So first of all, I'll show you just one way, and then after that we'll just do it in a recursive way. So here in the code, now let us just loop through this root category children. So I'll say here for each root category children as child like this, and here we'll again do the same thing over here like this. So we'll just say here instead of the root category, we'll just add here child like this, and here also we'll add child, and here we'll write all categories. So we are just repeating the same code over here. Now let me come here in the Tinkerbell and just reload here. Now you can see here I am getting the children for this category as well. But in the database, this also has its children. But guys, if you see here, the first children of this category is starting with the index of 5. And we don't want that behavior, because whenever we pass this in a JavaScript, it will treat it as an object. So let us fix this. We'll just reset the keys here. So we'll just do here values like this, and here also we'll do values, and if I come here and reload, now we can see here all those keys are gone. Now they will act as an array whenever we pass them in a JavaScript as well. Now to get the children of this one also, we don't want to do this for each loop one more time, because there may be multiple level of categories. Let's say there is 10 levels of categories, so we don't want to do it 9 times or 10 times. So we'll do it in a different way using recursive function. So we are seeing a pattern over here. So we'll just repeat it. So we'll create a private method over here, and we'll say format tree like this. Now here we'll pass the categories that we want to format, and we'll pass all the categories, because here if you see here closely, we need that all categories everywhere. So we'll just pass the categories that we want to format, that will be categories and all the categories like this. And now I'll just copy this here and I'll just paste it over here. And instead of root categories, we'll just say categories like this. And instead of root category, we'll say category like this. And here will be the all categories because we have named it the same thing. Now instead of doing for each loop over here, we'll just call this format rig once again because it is doing the same thing over here. So here we'll say self format tree, and now here guys we'll pass this children over here, and the second parameter will be all categories like this. And also guys, let's say if there are no any children, then we don't want to do this, so we'll only do this if there are children. So let's say if category children is not empty, then we'll perform this operation. So here guys, if the children is not empty, then it will call this own function, okay, and it will pass this children over here, and again it will loop through the children and it will check in the all categories if it has more children. And again, if it has more children, then it will again go through this loop and it will again come here. And let's say if it doesn't have any children, then it will just stop here and it will not execute this function anymore. So we are just calling the same function recursively. So now here we'll just call the format tree here. We'll say self format tree and we'll pass root categories and all categories like this. And since all the categories are the object, so it will mutate those object and we don't have to just assign it to anything. Even if we pass the root categories, these root categories will automatically contain all the children. So now let me go here in the Tinkerwell, and you can see here there are three levels of categories here, 1, 2, and 3. This 11 doesn't have any children over here. Now whenever I reload, it will also have the children. So here I'll reload, and you can see here guys, this 11 also has the children. And since this 14 doesn't have any children, so it stopped here and it did not execute that recursive function. So in this way, you can only run one query and format the categories up to n levels. So it can be any number of levels here guys, it doesn't matter, it will just format it. So that's it for this video guys, and if you want anything that I want to cover, then just let me know in the comment section below and I'll make a video about that as well. So thank you for watching, have a great day, bye.